Well, here are many old lamp parts. I'm actually in the market for an oil lamp font, but it has to be the right size, and I don't see any here. That's a nice acorn shade there for a pendant light fixture. That's only $10. Look at this matte green piece of pottery. It says on there, vintage green, $20. It looks like an old one too. Bathroom light shades. Oh, here's a great big old, usually these are called carriage blankets, and they are heavy, heavy and thick. That feels like mohair. And this is to throw over you to keep you warm in an open carriage. That's nice. $75. Sometimes the colors on this are a little drab. Oh, darn it. Some of you are going to get that joke and some of you aren't. Right? I have a feeling that most of my audience knows what it means to sit around darning socks. Does anybody still do that? Look at this. $80 for a Roseville Jardiniere. Some more silver crust. And some Ellie Smith glass. Hello, baby. Lamps and parts, hardware. I love all this stuff. There's another pair of dresser lamps. And this is $25 for the pair. Did I or did I not buy the ones that you saw me fiddling with a little while ago? I bet you probably have a good idea that I did. Yeah, I'll go ahead and tell you. I bought them. Because it's a set of three. I'll show them to you later. And talk about them a little bit. Now let's see, what's back here? That's a lampshade. These are just new decorative things. Well, there is a lot to look at. There's got to be some bargains in here too, floating around. I have a Danish modern candlestick holder over there, I guess. Bunch of baby dolls. Okay. Little knickknacks. Quite a bit of blue willow we just passed. Dresser boxes. I guess 1940s dresser lamps. Cups and saucers. Plastic fruit that always got sticky. Why did that plastic fruit always get sticky? I see another Dante and Beatrice down here. Oh, well, it's nice to see that they're losing their paint just like the set that I have. Nicole painted, let's see. Yeah, Dante and Beatrice, $35 for the pair. Date to about 1930, nice and heavy. Linens and things. There's your Christmas apron. Ouch. I really need to watch where I'm walking. I'm gonna make some mistakes. Okay. Look at these. The two Humpty Dumpties. I guess it's two. I wonder why there are two. Well, I know it's salt and pepper, but I guess Humpty has a friend. Maybe that's Humpty and that's Dumpty. I don't know. Spaghetti poodles. They're $22 each. I didn't tell you how much Humpty Dumpty was. I can't really get to the price tag that easily to tell you. All right, I am watching the floor. This is Spaghetti Santa. And he's only 12. So that's okay. Ouch. Oh, look at all the jewelry. Jewelry boxes or jewelry caskets. A lot of these are made by Jennings Brothers. When you see a JB on the bottom. Not all of them, but many of them. I've bought and sold a few before. I don't think I have any in my inventory right now. Some moonstone. Anchor Hocking. A few Art Deco clocks. Look at all the irons on the floor. Does anybody iron anymore?
Roll 'em, girl, roll 'em. Go ahead and roll 'em. Roll 'em down and show your pretty.
I don't know. I even think my mother rarely gets her iron out, but I know when I was a kid, the ironing board stayed up all the time. And she ironed all of my father's white shirts. For work, he wore a white shirt every day. And she ironed those shirts. You remember how everybody wore those power suits back in the 1980s? And three-piece vests were still popular. Look at the depression glass. I wonder what this is. A mug. He's the chief, and he says, Indian mug, $10. I'm having a hard time seeing that mark on the bottom. Maybe you picked it up. I couldn't quite get my progressive lenses in sync. to see what that said. $8. That's a little custard glass flower pot. In the 40s. Some more marigold carnival glass. And that looks like the model train corner. We won't go in there. I'm not in the market for any model train stuff. No, I put it all away. My dad's set. But they're like old friends taking them out every Christmas season. Mm-hmm. Well, let's see what's in this closet. It looks like it's going to be dark. And it is. Oh, not that bad. Lots of depression glass to be seen in here. Actually, it is kind of dark. There's the amber mixing bowls. I'll look because sometimes I need some orphaned pieces to match up with other things that I have. I don't see anything that I need. Oh, I thought I won a prize. Doggone it. Did you hear that little ding-a-ling? I thought I won a prize. But it was just somebody coming in the front door. Oh, well. There's the nice hawking piece in ruby red with the birds on it. I think I just sold one in the Vitrock with the birds on it. That certainly is a Royal Hager glaze on the two of those matching vases, no doubt. I can't see a price. Oh, look what someone has done here. They've recycled leaves from the old porcelain kitchen tables and made shelves out of them for their kitchen collectibles. Well, I hope they didn't tear up good tables to do that. I mean, if the tables were in bad shape, that's a good idea for recycling. So many things from the 1930s. Boy, I love the color on this. Deco vase, $25. Okay. Mm-hmm. What do you see, everybody? What do you see? I see Jadeite by Fire King. I see Modern Tone by Hazel Atlas. And here's this mid-century pine cone stuff. Dinner plates. Is it pine cone? I guess it's pine cone. Oh, here's this again. I was talking about this the other day. Fair Lane? Is that what it says? Fair Lane? Very late 50s, early 60s. Mm-hmm. I don't know who gave all of that to my mother and father upon their wedding, but they never used it, or at least I don't ever remember it being used.
Thank you.